So, welcome to Weld.com. Today we're going to do the flux-cored basics with Franken Fab Bob. Franken Fab Bob has done some flux-cored work, but non-gas, without the gas, non-gas. So we're going to do it with the gas today. And we're going to use the Everlast Multi-Process Lightning MTS 275, and we're going to use 7525, and we're going to use right at 20 CFH on the gauge. And the wire we're going to use is the Bowler Diamond Spark 50TRC 045 seamless flux core welding wire with an AWS spec of 5.36. So this is a very, very basic course to get the beginner started and understanding how to weld flux core. So what do you think about it, Bob?
I'm excited, man. We've done, like you mentioned, we've done a lot of little mini flux core things. We've got a little small buzz box in our shop, and right. We do little hobby welding things, but I've never done big wire. We're using 045 wire and shielded gas as well. So I'm excited to get out here and test some coupons out and get a better knowledge for some flux core MIG welding.
So I'm gonna show the settings on this Everlast multi-process, Lightning MTS 275 machine. It's a multi-process machine, so it'll TIG, stick, and MIG. So we're gonna do the MIG process today. So you can see it's got a selection up here. MIG steel, C25. But the reason why I'm using the MIG steel C25 is because we're using 7525 today with the flux core wire that we're using. Just carbon steel, you don't really need a lot of preflow. It's not like you weld stainless or any Haskell or anything like that. So we'll just go up to one. And then we'll go to the next setting. And if the wire feed speed to start at 60, we'll start there. Upslope. I got upslope. I'll go up to, it goes up to 10 or 1.010. So I'll go, we'll try 3. So then we'll go down to the burn back, which I like to set the burn back about halfway. So it goes up to 2. So I'm not even going to go halfway. I'm going to go a quarter. I'm going to go to 0.5. So there's 0.5 on the burn back. So the down slope, I'm going to go back. Like I said, it goes all the way to 1, and I'm going to go to 5. So we'll go to the next one. Wire feed speed at the end, we'll keep it on 60. Go to the post flow. Since we're not, like I said, we're only welding carbon steel, I'll set it on 2. And then of course your inductance. I like inductance about 35%. So that's what we'll do on that. And of course we're on 2T. So we're gonna start off with a wire feed speed. I'm gonna start off about 360. 360. And then we're gonna start at 22.5 volts. And what we'll do is we'll go to 22.5. And me and Bob will burn a couple passes or one pass, and Bob will burn a pass, and then we'll talk about it. But we're gonna go down on the volts and same wire speed, and we're gonna go up on the volts with the same wire speed, and we'll compare it. So as you can see, we got our two A36 3/8 thick plate with both 30 degree bevels with a 1/8 landing and a 332 gap. Bob wants a 332 gap, so guess what Bob gets?
332 gap.
So we're gonna go from there, and just like I said, he's gonna pushing it or pulling it, whatever you do, 15 degrees with about a 5/8 stick out. 5/8 stick out.
Yep, I'm gonna run some of these. I'm gonna run this first set of passes. I'm probably gonna drag these backhand, and we're gonna get it tacked up, and I'll pull it this way. But I think this is a good start for anybody looking to get into flux core. If you know MIG, this is a very similar concept, but I don't know much about flux core, so this is where we're getting started, and this is gonna be a good process for us. Thank you.
So you can see Franken Fab Bob ran that root. And it looks pretty, it looks really good and consistent. Looks but we'll find out how nice. Consistent it is when we turn it around. Look at the root. So here it is. So he started out really good. Of course, that was his tack up here. So he started out really good, going really good, going really good, going really good. Then wham, something changed. And what I can just figure out, what do you think, Bob? Just instead of putting a wire dead in the V groove, yeah. You might have just built up on the bevel.
Yeah,
and then it didn't break it down as well.
I agree. I didn't keep that penetration, and I must have stepped off somehow, and then I stayed on top of my impurity, and I carried it all the way to the end of the plate. So you that's live and you learn.
Yeah, right. So just like Bob explained before, you know, this is just basics for flux core welding. So this is what happens. This is the basics, you know, that you want to learn out there in the audience of what to do and what not to do.
Don't do this.
So, as you can see, Bob ran a nice filler pass in there. It filled in the sides, tied in real good. Had little BBs here that he knocked off with a grinder, which is fine. But both the sides are tied in really nice. It looks really good. And we turned it up a little bit. We turned up the volts like 10 volts. We started and put the root in at 22.5 or 22.5. We put the fill in at 23.5, but kept the same wire speed at 360. For the root and the fill. It looks really good, Bob. For someone that said you don't know how to flux core weld,
yeah.
Looks pretty good.
Thanks.
And another thing is, that weld looks so good and so tight, it's like my welding cap. Them Como caps.
They I like fit. Them caps.
They fit good. Look how good this thing fits.
It's nice. It's slick.
Nice and snug and slick.
Reversible.
Right where I like it.
Reversible. Cover your ears. They're nice, man.
So shout out to Como. Thanks for the hats.
Dig
and anybody out in the audience ever ask about what kind of welding cap you should buy? Como's the cap to buy.
Get them. Local welding shops approved.
Yep. So we're going to go on to the first pass of the cap. We're going to leave it on 23.5 volts, or are you going to go up a little bit? What do you think?
Let's try kicking it up a little bit, and we'll see how it runs, and then we'll be able to adjust it. We'll have a good idea of what our temperature settings is, and then we'll determine whether we need to come up or down for our last cap pass.
So we'll go to 24 on this one?
Yes, sir.
24 volts and leave it 360 wire speed?
Let's do it.
All right, let's do it.
Fire in the hole. Look at that slag. That's my first flux-cored slag peel, everybody.
So as you can see, we turned the volts up 5, so this is at 24 volts and 360 on the wire speed, and come out really nice. It might have threw a BB here and there. You take a grinder, wipe that off. But as far as the overall cap looks, the profile looks really good. And another thing is, this is why we like these Bowler products. Look at the flux. It falls right off in one piece. So that's a good thing. And that also tells you that your heat, your angle, and your speed is right on point, because that's what happens when everything falls together. Your flux falls off just like that. And for you beginners out there, just like Bob walked in here and said, I've hardly ever done any flux core welding. So this just goes to show, an experienced stick welder, you can make him a really good flux core welder. And that proves it right there.
I dig it. I like it.
Bob, you did a really good job.
I appreciate it, man. It, you know, for anybody out there that's just getting into flux core over MIG welding, it has a lot of similar characteristics. You know, it's still, you know, a MIG gun, but it also carries that same characteristics like a stick welder, and it has, you know, slag peel type of thing. It's different. It's another process. I really like it. I really appreciate Paul, you bringing me out and letting
anytime,
me try this.
Anytime, my pleasure.
Obviously, I still got some more practice to do. I'm not going out and selling flux core weld jobs just yet. You know, I definitely need some more practice. Obviously, got to work on my roots too. But I'm excited. I'm excited for the new process. I'm excited to get out and try it in my shop and in the field, and then, you know, end up selling some work in the future with it.